Okay, so we have seen what operators are, what linear operators are. We discussed the crucial concept of eigenvalues and eigenvectors corresponding to linear vectors in an arbitrary linear vector space. So now in this lecture we will define an important class of linear operators, namely Hermitian operators, and also look at some consequences for the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of Hermitian operators, you know, just from their property of hermeticity, which we will describe in this lecture. Okay, an operator is called Hermitian or self-adjoint if it's self-adjoint, meaning the adjoint operator corresponding to this operator is itself. So H dagger is equal to H, right? Hermitian operators are of great importance in quantum mechanics, and as a result of two crucial properties that we will discuss in this lecture, right? So in quantum mechanics, we know that all physical observables, you know, correspond, there are operators corresponding to all physical observables, and these operators have to be Hermitian, right? And you know, one reason for this is the two properties that we will describe in this lecture. And before we go to these properties, you know, let's point out an important fact, right, based on what we have already defined, right? So we have said that every ket operator corresponds to a bra operator, every ket vector, right, there is a corresponding to this, there's a dual vector in the dual space which is called a bra vector and which is denoted by this symbol. So we can ask, suppose we take some linear operator and act on, you know, this some vector x which is a ket vector, then we know that A acting on x will give you another vector which is also another ket vector. So what would be the vector which is dual to this? What is the vector in the dual space, right? So clearly you would guess that there would be some relationship to, you know, the bra vector x, but what is the precise vector? So let's define A acting on x to be some other ket vector y, right? We are interested in the dual vector, you know, this bra y. Now suppose we consider the inner product of some other arbitrary vector x naught with y. We know that one of the essential properties is inner product of x naught with y is the same as the inner product of y with x naught with a complex conjugate, right, on it. So we have, but y is so y x naught star is equal to x naught y, but y is A acting on x, so x naught ax, right? But by definition of the adjoint operator, we have, you know, this matrix element x naught ax is the same as x a dagger x naught, the whole thing complex conjugate. This is the definition of, you know, the adjoint operator with using matrix elements, right? So we have y x naught star is the same as x naught ax, which is the same as x a dagger x naught star. So removing the complex conjugates on both sides, we have y x naught is equal to x a dagger x naught, right? And thus we have, you know, this stuff. You can look at this stuff. You have, you know, this is a bra space vector, and you so have a bra space vector that you are going to, you're taking the inner product of this with the same vector x naught, and this holds for any arbitrary x naught. Therefore this bra space vector y is the same as, you know, this bra x with a dagger, right? So this is the vector that we are interested in, right? So whenever you have, you know, x, the ket x corresponds to the bra x, and a x corresponds to x a dagger, right? So this is an important fact, right? Now, and this is intimately connected to you know, this antilinear nature of this inner product operation, right? When you, if we have seen that if you have, you know, alpha times x plus beta times y, and if you take the dual vector corresponding to alpha x plus beta y, it's going to become alpha star and beta star, right? So if you consider inner product operation, although if you take if the ket vector has some alphas and betas involved, they will just come out, but if those linear combinations are in this bra space, that's going to give you alpha stars and beta stars, right? So this a dagger also corresponds to this, you know, this antilinear nature of the inner product operation, right? So they're all very closely related. But anyway, so this is a fact that which we will have to use in all kinds of manipulations when we are working with ket vectors and bra vectors. So you might as well, you know, spend some time and understand it well. Okay, so now let's go to our two crucial properties of Hermitian operators. Property number one is that eigenvalues of Hermitian operators are real, right? So how does this come about? So the eigenvalue equation is H acting on X is equal to lambda X. So you have given some we have managed to find some eigenvector with X and its eigenvalue is lambda X. So now let's take the dual space vector of this. So we have just seen that if you take the dual space vector, it's going to be bra X H dagger and is equal to lambda star. You have to do this, right? So this is the antilinear property. When you take any constant is associated, if you multiply a ket vector with a constant, the bra vector will be multiplied with the constant, the complex conjugate of that constant, right? So lambda star X. Now, but H dagger is the same as H. That's the defining property of the Hermitian operator. So you have X H is equal to lambda star X. Now taking the scalar product with the bra vector in equation one, right? So, and with the ket vector in equation two, we have X H X is equal to lambda. So direct, so if I bring in X from the left hand side in equation one, right? So then I get X H X is equal to lambda X X, but I could have also, you know, brought an ket X here from the right side here. So then it will give me lambda star XX, so which is equal to lambda star XX. Both of these are equal to, you know, this matrix element X, H, X, which comes from the hermeticity of this operator H. Since the eigenvector X is non-null, this immediately implies that lambda is equal to lambda star, right? There's no other way, right? If you have the equivalence of these two and X is non-null, that means lambda must be equal to lambda star, which implies that lambda is real, right? That was the first property, right? And this is a property that's essential for physical observables, right? Eigenvalues of Hermitian operators of which correspond to observables, the eigenvalues are really where the physical information is, and that has to be real. That's why this theorem is of great importance in quantum mechanics, as you might have seen already. The second property is that eigenvectors of a Hermitian operator corresponding to distinct eigenvalues are orthogonal, right? So let's see how this comes about. So suppose you have two eigenvectors x1 and x2 and distinct eigenvalues lambda1 and lambda2 respectively. So we have these two equations, h acting on x1 is equal to lambda1 x1 and h acting on x2 is equal to lambda2 x2. Now if you take the dual of, you know, the first equation x1 h lambda1 x1, I have already used the fact that h dagger is equal to h and lambda1 star must be equal to lambda1 because it's a Hermitian operator. Now if I take the inner product with this vector x2, here I have x1 h x2 is equal to lambda1 x1 x2, but I could have calculated the same matrix element in an alternate way. I can go to equation 3 and then multiply, or you know, take the inner product from the left side with x1 here in the second equation, then I have x1 h x2 is equal to lambda2 x1 x2, right? So I have for the same matrix element but two different values computed here, lambda1 x1 x2 or lambda2 x1 x2. Both of them are the same. So lambda1 minus lambda2 times x1 x2 equal to 0. And we have been told that lambda1 is not equal to lambda2, right? That's part of the proposition of this statement. So they are distinct eigenvalues. So x1, the inner product of x1 and x2 is equal to 0, proving the orthogonality of the two eigenvectors, right? So a consequence of this is that the eigenvectors of a Hermitian operator, you know, are complete. They're able to span the whole space, and this is of paramount importance in quantum mechanics, right? So it means that you should be able to write any state, express any state as a linear combination of eigenfunctions of any observable, right? And so which means first of all that H becomes diagonalizable and it's a complete basis the eigenfunctions provide and so on, and it's of great importance, right? So here we have only we have shown that any two eigenvectors corresponding to distinct eigenvalues are orthogonal, but from this there is a consequence of this is completeness, right? So we will return to this later on when we look at matrices, right? So but at the moment we are looking at abstract operators, and this is a result that can be shown for abstract operators. So that's all for this lecture. Thank you.